We like to imagine that after there's been a verdict, that the story is over. The reality is, whether they're the offender or the victim, the journey is just beginning.
And I got a page from my wife.
Denise's phone rang.
And there was a sheriff's deputy at the door.
Nate had been in an accident.
Moving at 40 miles an hour and stops.
The first call that we got of shots fired.
And then she said, Loisha is dead.
The offender was high on heroin.
I got some drugs I used.
The deputy yelled, got a gun.
I just wanted to kill him because he was trying to arrest me.
I knew something had happened.
But the driver doesn't look so good.
I had reached down and grabbed my knife.
Her throat had been slit.
As I crest the hill, I
hit Nathan from behind.
All of the shots started ringing out.
She caught 7 bullets.
Do you even know what you did?
Took his gun from him.
I remember shouting.
Put it to his head.
Don't do it.
And I pulled the trigger.
Since the day it happened, my family and friends wanted him killed.
Ashley is 25 years old, and her future's gone.
I just wanted revenge.
And boy, I lost it that day.
So I was going to kill her.
What is it that you want to know?
I want him to look me in the face and tell me why he killed my mother.
I want him to understand he took somebody great, and no amount of jail time will fix that.
People say, I hope you get closure. There is no closure. Never.
How do you prepare yourself for staring across a table to somebody that has taken the life of your child?
Just what if he is still a violent person?
I don't know where we're going to land. But we're all in, man.